Morning everyone. Today we are going to start with our second part of the video of chapter 1, the story of village Palampur. Overview of the topic. The purpose of this topic is to introduce you with some basic concepts relating to factor of production which are involved in farming activities, and this is done through a story of imaginary village called Palampur. In villages across India, farming is the main production activity. Approximately 75% of the people who are working are dependent on farming for their livelihood. They could be farmers or farm laborers. The well-being of these people is closely related to production on the farm. Now, introduction. What type of village Palampur is? Okay, if you see in your book in the beginning, okay, description is given to tell you about the development level of this particular village. So depending upon the facilities available, we can say that Palampur is fairly well developed village. Why? Because it has a good system of roads, transport, electricity, education, school and healthcare center. And the social composition of the village has about 450 families belonging to different castes. 80 families are upper caste families who own majority of the land, and rest of the families are lower caste people. Now, topic 2, farming in Palampur. In this topic, we are going to discuss the factors of production which are involved in farming. The number 1 is land. Land is very important natural resource and it is fixed in nature. Fixed in nature means that we cannot increase or decrease land area. As the population is increasing, there is tremendous pressure on land to produce more and more to feed the increasing population. Okay, so the next subtopic of this main topic is there a way one can grow more from the same land? So basically you try to understand, as the population is increasing, okay, and land is fixed, to fulfill the needs of food of increasing population, farmers are using different methods so that they can produce more and more from that fixed land they have. Okay, so let's come to the topic. Since land is fixed to increase the productivity, farmers use different methods. These are, number 1, multiple cropping. To grow more than one crop on a piece of land during the year is called multiple cropping. It is the most common way of increasing production on a given piece of land. Farmers grow at least 2 main crops like wheat during winters, jowar or bajra during summers, and potato as the third crop. So here, what is the main point? That on a single piece of land, in 3 different seasons, farmers try to grow 3 different crops. Okay, now the second method is by using modern farming methods like use a high yielding variety of seeds, fertilizers, better irrigation methods, farm machineries. Okay, seeds, pesticides, fertilizers, farm machineries and irrigation facilities. All this help in increasing the productivity from the same piece of land. Now the next topic, will the land sustain? Obviously, when you keep on using the land again and again, okay, without giving it a rest to regain its lost fertility, okay, land is bound to lose its fertility. And to maintain the fertility, if you are using the chemical fertilizers, that also creates many environmental problems as well as it causes loss of soil fertility. So let's see, land being a natural resource, it is necessary to be very careful in its use. Excess use of land without taking proper care to maintain its fertility will lead to land degradation. Okay, now in class 8, all of you read about the Green Revolution. Okay, what Green Revolution is? A large increase in crop production by using this modern farming methods. Again, that is same high yielding variety of seed, fertilizers and all. So Green Revolution is not only helped in increasing the production of the crops, but at the same time it also associate with many environmental as well as water and land degradation problems. So green revolution, which is mainly associated with modern farming, okay, causes excess use of chemical fertilizers, which is now leading to the loss of soil fertility. And again, continuous use of land groundwater for tube well irrigation has reduced the water table below the ground, and environmental resources like soil fertility and groundwater are built up over many years. Once destroyed, it is very difficult to restore them. So excess use of land, okay, by using modern farming methods leads to problem of land degradation, and other problems like lowering of groundwater level. After that, the next subtopic is that how the land is distributed in Palampur. In India, generally, the land holdings are very small and highly unevenly distributed among the farmers. According to the size of their land holding, the farmer can be classified as big, medium and small farmer, and the fourth group is of landless farmers and laborers who depend on the land. Okay, let's see types of farmers. First is small farmers. They have less land holding, less than 2 hectares. Second category, medium farmers. They have land holdings more than 2 hectares. And the third category is of large farmers. They have land holdings more than 10 hectares, okay? And the fourth, landless labor who don't own any land, but they work in the field of medium and large farmers. And hectare, it is the standard unit to measure land, okay? So, then the question comes, why are the land holdings of Indian farmer is usually small? One of the main reason is the division of inherited father's property among the children, or in other words, we call law of inheritance. Now, what this law of inheritance is, let me explain with the example. Suppose A owns a 4 hectare of land, okay, and this A has 2 sons, B and C. After the death of the A, the land, the 4 hectare land gets divided among his 2 children B and C, and both of them get 2 hectares of land. Okay, now B and C both have 2 children, W, X, Y and Z. So naturally, after them, this 2 hectare land will be divided among these 4 children. So each will get 1 hectare of land. So you can say from A to W, X, Y, Z, a 4 hectare land is divided and now left with 1 hectare of land. And naturally, with the coming generations, this will further get divided. So it is one of the main reasons that in India, the land holdings are very small. Okay. Now, land distribution among the farmers. Okay. This table graph 1.1 is given in your book. See this graph very carefully and then try to understand. According to this graph, okay, 36% cultivated area, okay, is divided among 80% of the farmers, okay. So mostly they are small or medium farmer. So you can say large number of farmers own very small land holdings, and then 64% of the land area is divided among 20% of farmers, mostly rich or big farmers. Okay, this shows unequal distribution. Rich farmers are less, but they have large land holdings. Medium and small farmers are more in number, but they have less land holdings. Okay, so let's have a quick recap of this first factor of production. First of all, land is a natural and a fixed resource. To increase the productivity from the land, farmers use multiple cropping methods and modern farming methods. But excess use of land also leads to land degradation and lowering of water table, and land is unevenly distributed among the farmers in India. I hope these 4 subtopics of the first point is clear. Now we proceed to the next that is labor. After land, the labor is most important factor of production. Okay, now the farmers, from where they get the labor to do the work. As far as small farmers are concerned, they work in their own field. They don't have enough money to hire labor. Okay, but the medium farmers, since their economic condition is better, they sometimes hire the laborers, or sometimes they also work in their own fields. It is a large farmers who mainly hire the farm laborers, and sometimes small farmers also to work in their field. Now, conditions of farm laborers in Palampur, according to the lesson, but in general all over the country, is very bad. Most of the farm laborers work on daily wages, which means they don't have regular work. The day they have work, they get the wages, or the day they don't have the work, they don't get any wages. The condition of farm labor is not good. One of the main reason is that the farm laborers are not getting sufficient wages. Okay, in India, the government has set a minimum wages for all the laborers in the country, but because of heavy competition for work among them, most of them are paid very less. Okay, in short, I say the number of job opportunities are less, and people, those who want to get those job opportunities, are more. So because of that, what happens that most of the time employer, or in this case the large farmers, they don't pay them the full wages set by the government. Instead, they give them sometime half or even less than half of the wages. Farm laborers, they accept these wages. Why? Because if they don't, then the large farmer will give the job to somebody else. So they all are poor, they cannot afford, so that is why they are ready to work for the less wage. Now the next is capital. The third requirement in the factor of production is capital. The modern farming required a great deal of capital to buy different inputs for farming, like high yielding variety of seeds, fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides. Now, to buy all these inputs, farmer needs money. And let's see how this money is obtained by the different types of farmers. First of all, small farmers, their land holding is small. The productivity from the land holding is also less. So they don't have enough money to buy these inputs. So what they do? They take loans from money lenders or from large farmers. Medium farmers, sometimes they use their own savings to buy agriculture inputs or for farming. And so large farmers, they use their own savings, give loans to the small farmers, and they also earn money by doing non-farming activities. So this is how these three group of people, large, medium and small farmers, they obtained money or capital to buy inputs in the farming. Now you can guess easily, out of these three, who is in the worst condition. Okay, now let's come to the conclusion. So in this topic, we have seen the three factors of production: land, labor, capital, and how they are used in farming. Among the three factors of production, we found that labor is the most abundant factor of production. There are many people who are willing to work as farm laborers in the village, where opportunities to get work is limited. In contrast to labor, land is scarce factor of production because land area is fixed. Even the existing land is distributed unequally. And modern farming method required a great deal of capital, that is both fixed and working capital. Small farmers usually need to borrow money to arrange capital and are put to great distress to repay the loan. Therefore, capital too is a scarce factor of production, particularly for small farmers. Thank you.